Dear students, greetings of the day. In this video, we are going to continue our second lesson, The Wind on Haunted Hill. Okay. In last video, we had seen section 1 and section 2 in this lesson. Okay. In that, I hope you all learned what is meant by Haunted Hill. Then about three characters, Usha, Binya and Suresh, who are living in the village near to that Haunted Hill. Okay. Then we had seen what difficulties Usha had faced while she was staying in that ruined building. Okay. When she was staying there, she had seen two ghostly figures in that building. Okay. Up to that, we had seen in the last video. Now, let us move on to the section 3. Usha's heart was in her mouth. She had seen without a shadow of a doubt two ghostly creatures at the side of the room, and she wasn't going to remain in the ruined building a minute longer. Here, Usha was very much frightened after seeing that two ghostly figures. Okay, she was clear without any doubt that she had seen two human beings at the other side of the room. Okay, so she took a decision that she was not going to stay in the ruined building anymore. Okay. She ran out of her corner, ran towards the big gap in the wall through which she had entered. She was halfway across the open space when someone fell against her. She stumbled, got up and again bumped into something. Then Usha ran towards the big gap in the wall through which way she had entered into that building. Okay. While she was crossing the open space, someone had dashed against her. So Usha fell down and she got up and again she dashed into something. Okay. She gave a frightened scream. Someone else also screamed, and then there was a doubt, a boy's shout, and Usha instantly recognized the voice. Suresh, Usha, Binya, it's me, it's us. Here, Usha started crying in great fearness. Okay. At that time, someone else also screamed and started shouting. Okay. Then Usha heard a boy who is shouting there. Then, after hearing that voice, immediately Usha recognized the voice and she called the Suresh and Binya, because she knew the voice of Suresh and Binya well. So she easily realized that the two ghostly figures are Suresh and Binya. Okay. They fell into each other's arms, so surprised and relieved that all they could do was laugh and giggle and repeat each other's names. Here, what is meant by giggle? Giggle means laugh lightly. Okay. Here, they all are surprised and hugged each other and they started laughing and repeat each other's names. Okay. Then Usha said, "I thought you were a ghost. We thought you were a ghost," said Suresh. Here, Usha said that she thought that you two were ghostly figures in that lightning. For that, Suresh replied, "We thought you were a ghost." Like that, they shared their thoughts. Okay. They huddled together in the corner, chattering excitedly. "Come back under the roof," said Usha. They huddled together in the corner, chattering excitedly. So Usha asked them to come under the roof. After that, they joined together in the corner and started chatting, filled with more excitement. Okay. "When it grew dark, we came looking for you," said Binya, and then the storm broke. Here Binya said to Usha that when it grew dark, we came looking for you, but the storm started suddenly, so we stayed in this building. Okay. "Shall we run back together?" asked Usha. "I don't want to stay here any longer." "We will have to wait," said Binya. "The path has fallen away at one place. It won't be safe in the dark in all this rain." "Then we may have to wait till morning," said Suresh, "and I am feeling hungry. Here Usha was not interested to stay in that building anymore. Okay, so she asked Binya and Suresh that shall we run back together to our home. But Binya asked them to set them to wait till the rain over, because the path which they have to travel has fallen away at one place. So she felt it wouldn't be safe to go home in the dark night. Okay, by hearing this, Suresh said that I think we may have to wait till morning to reach our home, but now I am feeling hungry, like that Suresh said. Okay, the wind and rain continued, and so did the thunder and lightning, but they were not afraid now. They gave each other warmth and confidence. Even the ruins did not seem so forbidding. So the wind, rain, thunder and lightning were continued, but now they are not feeling afraid because they gave each other kindness and confidence to stay there. Okay, even the ruined building did not seem to be fearful for them now. Okay, after an hour, rain stopped, and although the wind continued to blow, it was now taking the clouds away so that the thunder grew more distant. After 1 hour, rain had stopped, but the wind continued to blow, and it was taking the clouds away, so the thunder grew more in distant places. Okay, then the wind too moved on, and all was silent. Towards dawn, the whistling thrush began to sing. Its sweet broken notes flooded the rain-washed ruins with music. After some time, the wind too stopped, and all remains very silent. Okay, now it is a time for early morning. Okay, so the birds whistling thrush started to sing. So the sweet broken notes of the birds music was filled in that ruined building. Okay, let's go, Usha said. Usha, come on, said Suresh, I am hungry. Then they all started to move from that place. Okay, Suresh said he was feeling hungry. Okay, as it grew lighter, they saw that the plum tree stood upright again. Although it had lost all its blossoms, they stood outside the ruins on the brow of the hill, watching the sky grow pink. A light breeze had sprung up. Okay, as it grew lighter, they saw that the plum trees were stood straight again. Okay, upright means straight again. Okay, although it had lost all blossoms, then they stood aside the ruins on the edge of the hill, and they were watching the pink glowness of the sky. Okay, then the gentle breeze wind had started blowing in that place. Okay, when they were some distance from the ruins, Usha looked back and said, can you see something there behind the wall? It's like a hand waving. I can't see anything, said Suresh. It's just the top of the plum tree, said Binya. After reaching some distance from the building, Usha looked back and said, can you both see something in that building behind the wall? For me, it's like someone is moving their hands. Can you able to see that? For that, Suresh said, I can't see anything there. But Binya said, from here, I saw the top of the plum tree, like that they were discussing. Okay, they were on the path leading across the saddle of the hill. Then they were started walking on the path leading across the saddle of the hill. Saddle means ridge between the two summits on the hill. Okay, they are started walking on the path leading across the ridge between two summits of the hill. Okay, goodbye, goodbye, voices on the wind. Who said goodbye? Asked Usha. Not I, said Suresh. Not I, said Binya. I heard someone is calling. It's only the wind. While they were walking, Usha heard the voice that someone is saying goodbye to them. So Usha asked, who is saying goodbye? For that, Suresh and Binya said, no, we are not saying goodbye to anyone, but we heard the voice of someone calling us. So we think it's only the sound of the wind, like that they are talking. Okay, Usha looked back at the ruins. The sun had come up and was touching the top of the walls. The leaves of the plum tree shone. The thrush sat there singing. While walking, Usha looked back at the ruins. The total atmosphere of that building had changed. Okay, the sun had came up and was touching the top of the leaves. Then the leaves of the plum trees were shining in the sunshine. Okay, moreover, the singing bird was sitting there and started singing. Okay, come on, said Suresh, I am hungry. Goodbye, 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 goodbye. Usha heard them calling, or was it just the wind? Suresh felt hungry, so he asked Usha and Binya to walk towards their home. While walking, Usha heard the voice of goodbye once again. At that time, she had a confusion that someone was calling them, or was it just the voice of the wind? Okay, like that, she had a confusion. Okay, okay. Lesson got over now. I hope you all understood this lesson well. Now I will give you the homework. Read the glossaries given in the lesson and write the test. Okay, then we move on to the book bag exercise. First choose it. The wind hurried and passed through the pines and deodars. Okay, the answer for the first one is B option, pines and deodars. Okay, second one, the market was dash away from the village, 3 miles. The answer for the second one is 3 miles. Okay, third one, Usha went to visit her dad's house after shopping in the market. The answer for third one is ant, B option. Okay, fourth one, Usha took shelter in the dad's ruins. Okay, Usha took shelter in the ruins. The answer for fourth one is A option. Okay, fifth one, at dawn the dad's began to sing. Which bird began to sing at the early morning? Thrush. Okay, the name of that bird is thrush. Okay, the answer for the fifth one is C option, thrush. Okay, okay, read this, choose it also, and then write the answer. Okay, okay, students, I will meet you in the next video. Thank you.